Hello guys and welcome back. So in this video here I'm going to try to repair my Makita drywall screwdriver. So it's a Autofeed drywall screwdriver. And what exactly is happening with this tool here? It's just going to get stuck with screws right on the tip here. I believe you get the same problem because it's quite common with these guns here to have that type of problem. So in this video I'm going to try to repair it and make it hopefully work. Okay, so first of all I'm just going to take this main bit out and you just unscrew and you take it out. So all our problem is here. So instead of changing all this bit, which is going to be quite expensive, I'm just going to try to repair it today. Okay, but one of the problems that it could cause the screws to block is the bit. Now to take the bit out, you just press and take it out. Now, because of the pressure that we are going to put on these bits, they are going to get consumed quite quickly and they will need changing periodically. To change them, you have to be careful also what you are going to put in, because you are going to have more than one type, right? So depending on what screws you are going to get, you can use a Phillips or posi drive. Now a posi drive, you might know it, it's a PZ2 and the Phillips is PH2. In this case here the length is 157, so my bit here it's 157, because there are others that are going to go even a little bit bigger than that. So first thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to change it with a PZ and I'm just going to put a brand new one. But that is not going to solve the problem because I already tried that. And yeah, the main problem is in this bit here. Is this tip that needs changing. So I have a new one here. I already tried it and it's working a little bit better. That doesn't mean it's not going to get stuck any screw. You might even get that sometimes, but definitely less than what is going to do now. Now, one of the problems that you can have with this gun is the way that you are going to use it, because usually these are going to get a lot of dust and are going to be thrown around the site a lot, and that can be one of the problems. Make sure you are going to clean it and not to have too much dust inside all these gears here, right? So right now we are going to change this guide here, which is from Makita, and it's a Autofeed screwdriver guide box shoe nose piece. That's how they call it, 6843 or 6844. And yeah, let's just do that. It's not going to be very difficult. And we are just going to change this guide here. Now, to do that, we have a small gap here, and on the other side also, I will just need to push them in. And this tip is just going to go out. As you can see, is missing one of these small, let's call it doors. guides. See, we have two on this side and just one on that side. So that is because I forced it a lot. I just lost it. It seems that I break it. That's what's happening when you are going to force more screws into it. So what exactly do you need to do? Just clean it a little bit and you are just going to insert it inside. Make sure that the stops went inside and is not going to go out, because it can happen that once that you are going to put the screws in and you are going to try to screw into the plaster board, this tip is just going to go out if you don't push it nice and tight inside. Right, and pretty much that's it for our repair here. Now we just have to see if it's going to work. And of course, before I'm going to forget, sometimes when you are going to buy this small box shoe, you can buy it together with the plastic that is going to come with this gum rubber that is going to come on top. As you can see, mine, it's already been broken and it should need changing also. But I just bought that one for now, and hopefully it's going to do the job. So let's test it for now. Okay, so now I'm just going to insert it back. Close it down. Now for this test here, I'm just going to use a 40 mil screw, and it's already set on 40 mil. I don't know if you can see it there, it's 40. So if you don't know how to set, you just need to press these two buttons here, and automatically you can shift the tip in and out. And it's in, and it's 40 right now. I'm going to insert my screws. And I think we are ready for our test. Okay, so I have a piece of timber right here. Let's see if the job is done. Okay guys, so I especially left this side of the video just to show you what is going to happen when you do a mistake, like putting the wrong bit in your gun. So here, instead of putting the PH2 in the gun, I just put the PZ2 in the gun, and it's giving me a lot of trouble. Watch and see. Okay, so I just checked I have PH screws, so I had to change the tip. Let's see. So I think the screws, they will need to go deeper, and I'm just going to put put them a little bit deeper. Let's see. And that is definitely better. Now it's flush. The other ones are going to be a little bit higher, but I'm happy with this one. So let's try it a few more. Okay, now they are all nice and flush. And I think we just finished with our test. And the job, I think is done. And it's working better than before. Okay, guys. So you saw, it's not that difficult to repair it. But keep in mind, there are a few things that you have to do to keep your gun safe. And by saying that, I mean you need to not throw it around, clean it every time that you finish the job or you have the time. Don't leave a lot of mess inside that mechanism because it's very delicate. Third, be careful to the screwdriver bit. So that bit needs checking and changing. Because it's going to get consumed straight away. And four, of course, change this small bit here. Of course, before changing it, you just need to pull it out, clean it, inspect it, see if everything is okay, put it back and try to work with it. See if you solve the problem. Sometimes they might get stuck and just need a bit of cleaning. In my case, it's missing one of the slides, one of the guides. So it would have needed to be changed in my case. All right, guys, this is the end of our video and our gun is working for now. Like I told you, these are very delicate and you have to take good care of them. Possibly put them in a box. And yeah, our clip just came to an end right now. And of course, don't forget to like and subscribe and see you on the next one.